Meanwhile, the state government has gone to water over a plan to develop a caffeine and sugar-free energy drink for students. The education minister says it's a good idea, but now doesn't want his bureaucracy to be part of it.
It was this ad tucked away in the weekend newspapers that raised eyebrows. The government inviting businesses to develop a pleasant-tasting, low-priced drink to keep students alert in the classroom. The idea for an alternative to drinks high in caffeine and sugar coming from pupils at Melbourne's elite university high school.
I think it's good that students have recognised this as an issue and wanted to do something about it and have used the school to try and help them with that issue.
But after being alerted about the project, the minister's now washing his hands of it.
It's just not part of our business to market or manufacture energy drinks, and we're not funding any aspect of that project at all.
The opposition seizing on the confusion over the plan's future.
What Victorians really want is for this government to come up with a potion to keep itself awake, because this is a government that is asleep at the wheel.
And the energy drink controversy has prompted the Deputy Premier to reminisce about his own preferred methods of staying alert as a student when preparing for end-of-year law exams.
Well, lots of coffee, repeated games of poker.
Not necessarily effective.
I do own up to having gone to sleep in the back seat during a constitutional law lecture. Apart from that, it's all a blur.
Gareth Borum, 10 News.